You know who I think beats Tyson Fury? A guy that you sparred named Andy Ruiz. Andy's smart, he has power, very fast hands.
You know what? He, the same one that I thought that could be a good fight because he quick too.
He's very quick and he's got good experience. Defense. And then Wilder and him might fight. That'll be interesting.
Well, he's the only one I feel that can beat all of them.
That power.
I mean, you know, I sparred him.
Yeah.
I sparred him.
I remember.
And I'm like saying, I remember telling my friend, I said, look, hey, I said, this guy look like he can't do nothing. I said, boy, God, man, he got fast hand, good defense and all that. You know.
Don't judge a book by its cover.
Wait, you know. Yeah, that's how it is by anybody, because that's what kind of humility is, because you can't look at a person and tell they can't fight. Once they start moving, you can.
That's true. No, but sometimes, I'm sure you've been in those situations where you went to spar someone and they're built like an action figure, like a G.I. Joe, but your skills, your stamina.
Yeah. See, but that was the whole big thing about boxing. You cannot look at a person as an individual. If you ain't never seen them box, it's different. But once you start moving, then it's the guy get too close or he wait too long, he get hit. And there's so many ways you can beat a guy like that.
Which of your fights would you recommend people to watch to learn from? Like, what do you think? Is there one?
My whole thing, I don't really watch my fight that much but I tell you what, I think the greatest fight I fought with Dwight Muhammad Kwawi. It's just, at that time and the 12th professional fight, even be thrown in there with that much stuff on pressure with somebody who fight like that, it was quite different.
One time you told me that Pepsi gave you a billboard and you told Coke how much they paid, and Coke were so appreciative that you were honest, they gave you like $20 million or something.
Yeah.
How much?
Well, I think $20 million.
$20 million just for being honest, for saying Pepsi only.
I don't know if being honest, but the Pepsi put the sign red by Coca-Cola building.
They were a thorn in their behind. And that was for two or something. It wasn't for a lot of money. Was it for free even?
Oh, no,
the original.
Sorry. Yeah.
They didn't pay you, Pepsi.
Well, the Pepsi then, because the guy asked me, he said, can I use the picture?
And you're like, yeah, you're nice.
Yeah, you can use it, man. You know, it paid off.
But honesty is the best policy, because you told Coke they didn't pay me. And I always tell people, be honest.
Yeah, pretty much. My whole thing, I always been that way, because the fact of the matter is that I wasn't expecting nothing anyway.
Okay, last thing. Did you ever dream in all of your dreams that you'll be in a Snoop Dogg song, The Real Deal Holyfield?
I didn't know Snoop Dogg.
But you're in the song.
But I didn't even listen to the rap. But, the whole big thing, through time, I found out who it was and all that stuff. After me, he's a real cool guy.
That makes you immortal, too, in the hip-hop.
Yep.
There you have it. Evander, The Real Deal Holyfield. Make sure to follow him on social media. Ellie Sackback reporting. Ellie Sackback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sackback reporting. ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sackback reporting.